Hello friends, welcome to TextDigiCell. In this video, we'll make a very simple home automation system using ESP32, but you don't need any Wi-Fi connection for this project. You can control the appliances with Bluetooth, IR remote, and also from the manual switches. To make this project, you just need a ESP32 relay module and 188 IR receiver, so you don't need any custom designed PCB. And during the video, I will share the complete circuit diagram and all other details. So after watching the video, you can easily make this project for your home. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this project works. First, let me use the Bluetooth app to control the appliances from the smartphone, and I can easily control the appliances with this Bluetooth app. Now I can use this button to turn off all the lamps and this button to turn on all the lamps. Now let me use the IR remote to control these appliances, and again I can easily control all the appliances from this remote, and I can use this button to turn on all the lamps. You can configure any button to control these appliances. Now let me turn it off. Now I will use the manual switch to control these appliances, and again you can also use push button for that. So you can see I can easily control all the appliances from the Bluetooth, manual switch, and also from the IR remote. You don't need any Wi-Fi connection for this project, and the project is very simple. Anyone can make this after watching the video. So without any further delay, let's get started. To make this project, you need a ESP32, 8 channel relay module, 188 IR receiver, and to control the appliances manually, you can use the existing switchboard or push buttons. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. The circuit is very simple. You can see I have given the 5 volt supply to ESP32, IR receiver, and the relay module, and these switches are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. Now if you use push button, then you can refer this circuit, and again these push buttons are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. Then you can refer this circuit to connect the appliances with the relay module, and this control pin will be connected with the ESP32 GPIO pins as per the circuit which I have shown here. So the connections is very simple. Let me show you how I have connected all the components. I have connected all these components as per the circuit. Here you can see this is the ESP32, and some of the GPIO pin are connected with these switches. Now let me show you the connection. Here you can see this black wire is the ground pin, and one terminal of each switch is connected with the ground pin, as this is a common ground, and these wires are coming from the ESP32 GPIO pins. Here you can see, as I have shown you, these are the GPIO pin, and this wire are connected with the GPIO pin of the ESP32. So these switches are not connected with the AC supply. And here you can see some of the GPIO pin also connected with the relay module control pin, and I have given the 5 volt supply here, and this is the 188 IR receiver, and this is the AC circuit. Here you can see these are the AC lamps which are connected with the relays. Please take proper safety precaution while connecting these lamps with the relay. So this is the complete 5 volt circuit, and this is the AC circuit. Only the relays are connected with the AC circuit. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for this project. But as I said, you can also make this project without using any custom design PCB. Still, if you want to get this custom design PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with 3 simple steps. First, upload the GABA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color. Then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the component required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the component on the PCB. Now let me connect the ESP32 with the PCB. Then I will connect this IR receiver. Now I will connect the ESP32 with the laptop to upload the code. These are the code for this project. If you use switch, then you can refer this code. Here I am going to use the push button. So this is the code for the push button. You can download this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article. I will share the link in the video description. Then you can download the code from this button. Now if you use switch, just click here to download the code, and if you use push button, then click on this button to download the code. After that, you have to install the ESP32 board. You can refer this link. Then you need these two libraries for this project. I have already made a video on how to download the ESP32 board and the libraries in Arduino IDE. I will share the link in the video description. Now if I go down here, you can see these are the GPIO pins connected with the relay, switch and IR receiver sensor. Now again, let me go to the void setup. In the void setup, you can define the Bluetooth name. Here I have given the name ESP32_BT. You can give any name. Then here you can see this function is used to control the relays from Bluetooth, and with this function we are controlling the relays from IR remote. So here you have to update the hex code as per the remote you are using. You can use any IR remote. I have already made a video how to get the hex code from any IR remote. Again, I will share the video link in the description. Here you can see these are the hex code of the IR remote buttons which I am going to use for this project. So for button 1, this is the hex code. So to control the relay 1, I will use button 1 of IR remote. So I will copy the hex code of button 1, then I will paste it here. So in a similar way, I have to copy all this hex code and paste it here to control the respective relays. And here to turn on all the relays, I have used button 9. And to turn off all the relays, I have used the power button of IR remote. But you can use any buttons of the IR remote. Just get the hex code and update the hex code in the Arduino sketch. After doing these changes, you can directly upload this code to ESP32. For that, go to Tools, select the board as DoIt ESP32 DevKit V1 and proper COM port. Then click on the upload button. Now I will quickly install the Bluetooth app for this project. You can download the APK file from the video description. And I have made this app using MIT App Inventor. Now let me install this app. During installation, you may find some warning message as I have not submitted this app to Google Play Store yet. Now let me open the app. First, you have to pair the Bluetooth. So I have to turn on the Bluetooth. Then go to setting just to pair the ESP32. So here I have to search for new device. And this is our Bluetooth name, ESP32_BT, which you have given in the Arduino sketch. Now let me pair it. After pairing the Bluetooth, again I have to go to this app, then tap on this button. In the list, you have to tap on the Bluetooth name, which is ESP32_BT, and here you can see it is showing connected. So now I can control this relay module from the smartphone. Let me turn on all the relays. You can see all switch turn on. Let me turn off all the relays, and I can also control the switches individually from this app. Now I will connect the AC appliances with the relay module as per this circuit diagram. As you can see, I have connected these 8 lamps with the relay module as per the circuit. Now let me turn on the supply. Then I have to connect the Bluetooth with ESP32. I have already paired the ESP32 with the mobile Bluetooth. Then I can easily control it with the Bluetooth app. As you can see, I can easily control it. Now let me control it with the IR remote, and again you can see I can easily control all the lamps. Now let me control the lamps from the push button, and again I can control all the lamps with the push button. So this is a very useful home automation project you can make, and you can also join our Telegram channel TechStudyCell for more such home automation project ideas. Now if you like this video, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such project. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.